I want to tell you a story of great courage and conquering fears. I believe this was supposed to, I was supposed to have filled this twice if I put two scoops in it, but are you putting pots in the garbage? Good job. Yeah, that one doesn't really fit. Oh. Condensed milk. It looks weird. Ideally I would have not 1% milk, but whatever. I've never made AeroPress coffee before, so we'll see how this turns out. I wanted to sit down with my hot cup of coffee and do like a story time. Pero este estaba llorando. I think he's probably sleeping now, so I can probably stop walking very soon. And then I can drink my lukewarm coffee, which is okay because it's really hot out, and tell you this story. First, I want you to tell me in the comments below, what do you feel about spiders? How do you feel about spiders? What do you think of them? I'll wait for your comments. What do you think about really big spiders? Fuzzy, fat. Oh, getting the shivers again. Coffee's really good. Okay. What do you think of tarantulas? Do you know where I'm going with this yet? Last night, I was talking on the phone, late into the night. I was bemoaning the fact that I hadn't brushed my teeth and I needed to get up out of bed and brush my teeth. I did not want to get up. I was feeling so tired and cozy in my bed. Kids were sleeping already. Well, I finally decided to get up and go brush my teeth. So I start moving the blankets, wiggling around the kids. And I see something move out of the corner of my eye. And I look. I wrapped myself around myself and slowly edged into the middle of the bed. And I kept my eyes on that darn thing. Huge spider. Oh my gosh, I've never, ever, ever seen a spider nearly that big. Nothing close to that even. I started freaking out. I was like, what do I do? What do I do? What do I do? What do I don't know what to do. What do I do? Oh my gosh, what do I do? And the thing crawled, creepy crawled down the wall. It was like maybe a foot up on the wall. Went down the wall. Went into the corner between the wall and the floor, and it was just sitting there on the floor, edged right into the shadow. Thankfully, my light was on, because the other nights when we've gone to bed, I shut out all the lights so that my kids can actually go to sleep easier, because otherwise they get too distracted. Pero esta cosa had the bathroom light on, so it was kind of dim. So the light was here, right? The bed was here, and it crawled into this shadow from the bed. If I didn't know it was there, I wouldn't have been able to know where it was. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh.
Pero tranquila, sí.
Oh my gosh. No
lo puedo dar con el zapato en la mano.
He's like, you're gonna have to kill it. Keep your eyes on it. Don't let it out of your sight. You know, trying to just like relax me. Oh, I was like, who can I call? Of course, if Tomas was with me, I would have asked him to take care of it. I did not want to deal with it. My brother, so the bedroom that we're staying in is like far away, not super far, but just like across the way, separate from the house. And so I didn't want to run over here to get my brother. Besides, it was night, he was sleeping. I didn't want to run over here and potentially lose sight of the darn spider and then not know where the heck it was. So I couldn't really go get anybody. I called my sister-in-law, but she didn't answer her phone. Don't know if it's silent at night or whatever she does. Maybe it was dead, maybe it was off, who knows. No answer. I'm like, okay, maybe like the caretaker who helps around here, maybe I could call him, but I didn't want to wake him up either. Anyways, he's like 10 minutes drive away. I was like, what if the spider disappears in those minutes that I'm waiting? Oh my gosh, I'm looking around my room. What in the heck can I use to get this thing? It is, oh, it's like when you kill a small spider, it's like an insect. It's like a little smack and you're done, right? But this thing, I was like, I need to smack that thing so hard because it's huge, thick, fat butt. Oh, I keep getting the shiveries thinking about it. Holy cow. I'm not one of those people that is terrified or horribly sickened by spiders. I don't like them, but they're whatever. I've killed spiders before. But like this thing was so big, okay? Oh, okay. So I'm looking around my room. I'm like, I wish I had a broom because it would have the long handle on it and I could just stay on the bed and like smack that thing with the end of the broom. It's like, I can use my shoe, but like, oh my gosh, ew. I was looking like my suitcase, but I can't throw something at it because if I miss, the thing is gonna run off, right? I have to actually either hold my shoe or put on my foot. Tomas is like, put your shoes on. And I had to step onto the floor and grab my shoes and keep watching the spider, put my shoes on. So I put my shoes on and then I was gonna walk towards it around the bed, but he said, no, you should go onto the bed and around to, cause the spider was facing the corner, not towards the open space. So he's like, go in front of it. If it runs, hopefully make it run away from the corner, not into the corner where I wouldn't be able to reach it or under the bed. So thankfully this whole time it's just sitting there. I was like, this thing is gonna run so fast. As soon as it sees movement, as soon as it knows that something is coming at it. Oh, I don't want my feet on the floor now. Oh my goodness. I was seriously, oh. The thing is, I knew that this was a growth point, right? Like, I need to do this myself. There's nobody else to do it. And I need to kill it because if I don't kill it, I don't know if it's gonna end up in bed with us later in the night. You know, I wouldn't be able to sleep the rest of the whole night. And there was nobody else I could have do it for me. It had to be me. Oh, so I had my shoes on, crawled onto the bed in between my kids, right? Oh, I turned the other light on so I could fully see. I was scared that the thing was gonna run off too when I turned the other light on, but it didn't, it stayed there. So I crawled across the bed with my shoes on and then I was getting ready to step onto the floor and I was like, oh, I just cannot, oh, to feel the squish of that thing underfoot. Oh my goodness. Oh, I started just grossing myself out thinking about that. So I was like, Tomas, can I just like do it with my hand? Can I take it off my foot and do it with my hand? And he's like,
solo como te digo, tenés que tratar de si sale corriendo, tenés que seguirla, porque te digo que te pusiera los zapatos mejor.
Oh my goodness. So I took one shoe off, had it in my hand, my one foot with the shoe on it, I put on the floor, and I just ever so slowly leaned towards that darn thing, and oh, I started going towards it, and then I was like, okay, breathe, you can do this, you can do this, you're gonna smack that thing, it is not going anywhere, you're gonna get it, you can do this, just oh, so much just trying to be positive about it, and like, okay, you got this. Oh, and just try not to think about the nastiness. Ah! Y machuqué esa araña. Oh. After I smacked it at first, you know, the leg is like moving. And so I just watched it for a little bit, just like frozen and just like, oh my gosh, it's dead. Oh my gosh, it's dead. Okay, it's over, it's dead. You got this. And Tomas is like, you have to hit it again. Make sure it's done for. And so I just kind of like quickly squished it again and then put my shoe on top of it.
Oh, oh my God.
And I sat back on the bed and I just started like kind of freaking out again. I was like, okay, it's over. You did it. It didn't run away. It is dead, dead. Oh, qué cosa más horrible. Now the thing that I have to do is clean it up out of there. Yeah, I'll probably do that when I'm turning off the camera right now, but moral of the story, I knew. It was just like life telling me, here you go, here's something you need to use like to grow and conquer a fear type of thing. Like, life is so good to us, teaching us all the lessons that we need to learn. Everything that we go through is, we go through it for a reason. And with each fear that we have to face, with each small thing that we need to deal with and that we conquer and get on the other side of, you know, we feel good about ourselves. We grow a little, we get a little stronger. And well, I thought I was gonna dream, like have some terrible nightmares about huge freaking spiders, but I actually slept quite good. And then we woke up at like 6 a.m. to monkeys in the trees, which was really fun, so. Reminder that you can do things. We can do hard things. It has been a theme now, like facing those hard things and those challenges and realizing that I like to pass them things off to other people and be like, no, you do it. I'm not dealing with that. So.
Ugh. Here's my tools. I'll spare you the nastiness, but.
Tales of Costa Rica. Yo. I'm so covered in bug bites. I just itch everywhere. Bye.